All right, everyone. So what we're going to do now is we are going to go into a simulation that's actually not the natural selection simulation. And what it will allow us to do is be able to zoom in into that molecular scale and be able to see that connection between genes, proteins, and traits. Now, in the simulation, you will see a spider population, and some of you may actually remember the simulation from another unit that you've done previously. In this simulation, we'll be focusing on the feature of stripe color for this population of spiders. Now, here are the two spiders we're particularly going to be concerned with. The first is Otis, and Otis has a brown body and blue stripe color on his abdomen, which is the back part of his body. The other spider we're gonna be particularly concerned about is Ruby here, and Ruby has a yellow body with black stripes on her abdomen. All right, everyone, so here we are in this different simulation, and we have Otis here. As we mentioned before, Otis has a brown body with blue stripes on his abdomen. Now, there's lots, I can see a lot of moving parts here, and there's lots of different things happening. So let's make sure that we have a couple of the essentials down here as we are looking to understand at the molecular scale, what is going on that allows for these traits to be expressed. And particularly in this simulation, what we're thinking about is how is this trait for blue stripe color be able to be expressed? The first thing I want you to notice are Otis's genes. In this right-hand corner in the box, we can see Otis's chromosomes. Now, remember, chromosomes are those bundles of tightly wound DNA, and that's where the genes are located, on an organism's chromosomes. If we look at Otis's genes, we can see he has two T2 genes on this set of chromosomes. So he has a T2 and a T2. Now remember, those genes provide instructions for making proteins. Well, let's take a look at which proteins Otis has. So these T2 genes provide instructions for making the number 2 protein. I can see that in his cell that those T2 proteins, those protein number 2s, are floating around, and they kind of look like a rectangle with a rounded edge, okay? A rectangle with a rounded edge. Now, I want you to notice something else here as well. Right now, this number two protein is connected like a lock and key with another molecule. We can see that going on here as well. Now, let's take a look at what's happening and how that lock and key kind of model allows for the expression of the blue pigment that is in Otis's stripe color on his abdomen. Okay, so what we know is that Otis has these T2 gene versions, which we can see here, and those provide instructions for the number 2 protein right here. Now, I'm going to zoom in a little bit further, and what's important to note here is that those genes are providing instructions to make the protein in a very particular shape. And that particular shape allows for the protein to be able to fit in another molecule. And when that protein fits into that molecule, that allows for the expression of, for example here, the blue pigment. So it's kind of like that lock and key that I mentioned before. The genes provide instructions for the proteins to make this particular shape that fits together with a larger molecule. And when that fit happens, then it unlocks a blue pigment to be produced, which is what gives Otis that blue stripe color on the back of his abdomen. Okay, so now I remember we were concerned about Ruby too. Now remember, Ruby was a spider that had a yellow body color with black stripes on her abdomen. So I'm now wondering, how are the genes and proteins different between Otis and Ruby that's causing Ruby to have black on her abdomen while Otis had blue. So let's take a look here. Again, lots of moving parts. So let's make sure we walk through this together to see what's happening and why these differences in stripe color are occurring. First, let's take a look at Ruby's genes. Her gene versions, again, these are her chromosomes, those tightly wound bundles of DNA, and her genes are on those chromosomes. Now, Ruby has T2 and T3 gene versions on her chromosomes. So, what does that mean? Again, those genes are providing instructions for proteins. So, what I think this shows here is that Ruby is able to make the number 2 protein and the number 3 protein, which is different than what I just showed you with Otis. So we have these T2, T3 gene versions, which allow for the number 2 and number 3 protein to be created in Ruby's cells. We can see that here in her cell, we've got this number 2 protein floating around, and we have these number 3 proteins floating around. Now, the number 2 protein, like I mentioned before, is kind of like a rectangle with one rounded edge, but this number 3 protein is kind of like a crown. It has two pointy edges on it. And so we can see here that Ruby has both the number 2 and number 3 protein, and that's because her genes are providing the instructions for those two proteins to be made. Now, let's zoom in and see how this works in terms of shape and that lock and key model that we talked about earlier. Okay, so just like before, we can see our number 2 protein fitting in with a larger molecule, and that therefore is producing the blue pigment. Let's see that right here. Right here, we can see that number 2 protein connecting with the larger molecule, and that is producing this blue pigment. Now, on the other hand, we also have that number 3 protein because we have the T3 gene. And we can see here that that number 3 protein is also connecting with those larger molecules to be able to produce this black pigment. So we have both the number 2 and number 3 proteins connecting with larger molecules to create that blue or that black pigment, respectively. Now, here's a question. I am wondering what might happen if I changed one of Ruby's gene versions so that it would replicate Otis's feature for stripe color. What do you think would happen if I changed Ruby's T3 gene to T2? Pause the video and I want you to turn and talk to someone and predict what do you think might happen if I changed Ruby's T3 gene version to T2? Pause the video, talk about it, and then I'll be right back with you. Okay, so I hope you made a prediction. And hopefully that was based in this understanding that genes provide instructions for proteins. Okay, so we're going to change Ruby's gene, T3 gene. We're going to change that to a T2. And I want you to see what happens here. Okay, when we changed Ruby's gene version from T3 to T2, now, all that she is making is that number 2 protein, and therefore her stripe color has now changed to blue. What is happening here is that the change in that gene version changes the protein and that structure of the protein that can fit into the larger molecule, and thus only the blue pigment can now be produced. So changing that gene version changes the protein and the structure of the protein that's created, which changes what that protein can fit into, and thus changes the pigment color, which then changes the stripe color that Ruby has, which is now blue instead of black.